Welcome to the video news of the week. Senior citizens in the region are welcome to check out The Gathering Place, a new senior center that has been established at the St. Mark's Church building in Groveton. Starting on April 12th, the center will be open every Wednesday from 10:30 a.m. to 2 p.m. A soft opening is planned for next Wednesday, April 5.
We want people who are interested in maybe becoming part of the senior center to come and be able to see the space and also to feel the space. The altar was pulled out, lined with two pews, rows of pews down through, and it's all been removed. The rug that was up in what the church calls the chancel area, most would call a stage, the carpet was ripped up, the old boards were replaced with hardwood flooring, and then everything was sanded and revarnished. And the altar has been pushed back to its original place. We're going to have a coffee bar with tea and variety of coffees. We're going to always have fresh fruit on hand, popcorn, because you have to have popcorn when you're celebrating. And this is what this is a place of celebration. So we want people to be able to come and participate if they want, but we offer space where people can just sit and do activities or look at a book or just sit and be. We don't want people to think, oh, I don't want to participate, I don't want to be around, I don't want to engage. Still come and have a space and fulfill your needs. And we built a bridge with Tri-County Transit, who they're very excited about this and see the need and are going to provide a transportation to pick up and to bring people back home and designate it specifically here for that day.
I am so excited just to be able to say, come on in, let's sit down and talk. Let's do things that you haven't been able to do for a while. And to have the opportunity for the place, the opportunity for people that can find a way here through Tri-County is amazing. And to see the group of volunteers that we have, it's such a variety. Everyone is so committed. And it's the best thing I have seen happen in a long time in this community.
After visiting people in facilities, seniors in assisted living facilities, even though they're surrounded by people there to a certain extent, there's not always a lot of socialization, not always a lot of chance for people to just get together and talk or to appreciate an event or a program that's offered. I think there's a huge need. And like Nancy said, with the transportation available, we're making it as easy as possible for everybody that wants to be here to be here.
Kids craft activities, maple samples, and meeting Miss Vermont were all part of the Maple Weekend activities at April's Maple in Keelin, Vermont this past weekend. Reigning Miss Vermont, Alexina Fetterhan, posed with staff and visitors to the family-owned sugar house. This year marks the 10th year that April's Maple has been open and making maple syrup. This week, the Chronicle takes one more look at the photos of Arthur Rothstein, who traveled up to the North Country during the Great Depression and captured some photos of life in the region during that time. These images show a group of North Country farmers getting together for the Farmers Production Cooperative meeting in Groveton in 1936.
On Monday, fiddler Richard Wood and singer-guitarist Keelin Wedge brought a night of high-spirited music to the Rialto Theater in Lancaster. This pair from Prince Edward Island were presented by the Great Northwood Center for the Arts.
Away. At 83, the all been planted. I see the harvest in a faded memory.
Friday temps reach a high of 41 and a low of 33 with rain and snowfall. Saturday sees rain continue with a high of 54 and a low dropping all the way down to 18 degrees. Sunday temps range from a high of 29 to a low of 15. Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.